Hey everyone, Alex here. Today I'll be talking about understanding the basics of a accord and olfactory structures in perfumery. Alright, let's get started. So an accord is basically a blend of several different perfume ingredients that come together to form one distinct fragrance. This accord is balanced by volatility or fragrance intensity. We'll start with the traditional olfactory pyramid, which consists of the top, heart, and base. Here we have the top or head notes of your fragrance. These are the first notes smelled after applying a personal fragrance. They are also the most volatile compounds with the lowest molecular weight, which means they evaporate very quickly. They have a short life cycle, but they are the key to first impressions. Here you'll see citrus notes like lime and bergamot, or aromatic herbs like basil and lavender. Next in the pyramid, we have our middle or heart notes, which are typically considered transition notes as the base begins to appear. Sometimes the early phase of a base note can be unpleasant, so this would be used to hide the early stages during its maturation. Here you'll see floral notes like geranium, or a lilac. See green or foie gras, which means fern-like notes like pine and green tomatoes. Fruits like raspberries. And last but not least, oriental and aromatic spices like nutmeg or ginger. Next, we have our base notes. Don't let this thin line fool you. This is the foundation of your fragrance. On a molecular level, by nature, these are the heaviest ingredients, meaning these are the least volatile compounds and they evaporate very slowly. Here you'll find some of my favorite wood scents like cedarwood and sandalwood. Within your base, you might also come across oriental balsam notes like vanilla and tonka bean. That's all I'm going to cover today regarding the traditional olfactory pyramid. Next, let's move into further olfactory structures. Here's an example of the linear fragrance structure, which is only composed of one or two notes. For example, sandalwood and or vanilla. These fragrances are designed to stay the same from start to finish, with the individual notes working together as an accord. Next, we have a baseless or headless structure. The structure is pretty straightforward. It either doesn't have a head or it doesn't have a base. I wouldn't say this is a good example, but an example of this would be lime, pine, and rose, or black pepper, cedar, and vanilla. Next, we have the undulating structure. By definition, undulating means having a smoothly rising and falling form or outline. In perfumery, an undulating structure will show reoccurring waves of notes which phase in and out. This illusion is caused by using similar notes in the head and heart of the fragrance. An example of an undulating fragrance structure could include lemongrass, bergamot, citronella, ginger, and lang lang. The final structure I'd like to touch base on today is called the kaleidoscopic structure. As you can see, the kaleidoscopic fragrance structure is pretty complex. It uses various notes to create several different accords, all working in unison. They don't phase conventionally and they're relatively unpredictable. One more thing. Keep in mind that these structures that I've shown you today are a part of a much, much larger olfactory structure, which pertains to chocolate, aldehydes, leathers, musks. The possibilities are endless. There are actually no rules. You are free to experiment, so please do so. That's the end of the video. I hope this helped shed a little light on olfactory structures and accord. Like, comment, and subscribe.